आर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू द कैपेसिटर इज एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन अ कैपेसिटर. यस, कैपेसिटर इज ऑल्सो एन एनर्जी स्टोरेज डिवाइस. द एग्जाम्पल इज दैट इन द फैन द कैपेसिटर इज कनेक्टेड सो एज टू स्टोर द एनर्जी. नाउ हेयर वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ कैन इट स्टोर एनर्जी एंड इन वॉट फॉर्म इट स्टोर्स द एनर्जी एंड वॉट इज द एनर्जी फॉर्मूला. सो वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस डायग्राम. सपोज वी हैव अ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर एंड इनिशियली इट इज अनचार्ज्ड. सो टू चार्ज इट वी विल बी कनेक्टिंग इट थ्रू सम बैटरी ऑफ वोल्टेज वी. सो वॉट विल हैपन इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ इट्स चार्जिंग. इनिशियली सम चार्जेस विल बी डेवलप्ड एंड आफ्टर दैट द चार्ज विल कंटिन्यूसली इंक्रीज बिकॉज द कैपेसिटर इज बींग चार्ज्ड. सो वॉट हैपन्स एज सून एज वी स्टार्ट चार्जिंग द कैपेसिटर द अपोजिट चार्जेस आर डेवलप्ड ऑन द टू प्लेट्स. दैट मीन्स द वोल्टेज डिफरेंस इज क्रिएटेड बिटवीन द टू प्लेट्स एंड सपोज वी वॉन्ट टू सप्लाई मोर चार्ज then that charge has to face that voltage difference and to overcome that voltage difference the charge has to some work is to be done on that charge and that work is stored in the capacitor as its energy, electrostatic potential energy. So the idea is whatever work is done in shifting more and more charge over the capacitor, that work is stored in the capacitor as its electrostatic potential energy. Now let us understand its derivation. So suppose at any instant the voltage difference between the plates is V and we want to supply dq charge. So dq charge which is transferred against the potential difference V, so some work is to be done. So dW formula will be V into dQ. As we already know, voltage into the new charge is called the work done. Now voltage formula we have to convert in terms of capacitance because we are here finding the energy in terms of capacitance only. So voltage across any capacitor is always Q by C. This is the same usual formula of capacitance. We have just rearranged it. So V voltage formula is Q by C into dQ. Now as we already know, to get the total work done, we always integrate dW. So this is only the energy stored in the capacitor. Whatever work is done, that is the energy stored. So this way the total work done or total energy of the capacitor is integration of dW. That means integration of Q by C dQ. Suppose we are shifting, we are transferring the total charge Q over the capacitor. We can take it some other value also, capital Q or some any other symbol. So just now we are taking it as Q. Now you can see if we do the integration, Q dQ will remain inside, 1 by C will come out and Q dQ integration or X dx integration answer is X square by 2. So here it will become Q square by 2. Even after putting these limits, the answer will remain Q square upon 2C. Now you can see that here are two more boxes shown for the formulas that are simply the rearrangement of the terms. Like if the energy formula is asked in terms of Q and C, so we have got Q square upon 2C formula. In the same manner, if we replace this Q by CV, then we will get the answer in terms of CV only. So finally, if you see the steps, you will get half of CV square. So this formula is in terms of C and V only. Now think, this formula we have made in terms of Q and C. Second formula is made in terms of C and V. तो वी कैन ऑल्सो मेक द थर्ड फॉर्मूला इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्यू एंड वी. दैट कुड बी मेड अगेन बाय रिमूविंग सी फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला. सो इफ सी इज टू बी रिमूव्ड, क्यू बाय वी विल बी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एंड फाइनली वी विल ऑब्टेन दिस लास्ट फॉर्मूला. सो द स्टेप्स ऑफ गेटिंग द एनर्जी एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द कैपेसिटर्स आर वेरी सिंपल. गेट डी डब्ल्यू बाय वी डी क्यू, रिप्लेस वी बाय क्यू बाय सी सिंबल, क्यू बाय सी फ्रैक्शन एंड डू इंटीग्रेशन एंड गेट द आंसर. एनी वन फॉर्मूला इज ऑल्सो सफिशेंट. इट्स जस्ट दैट वी कैन कन्वर्ट इट टू सम मोर फॉर्म्स. नाउ आफ्टर गेटिंग द एनर्जी एक्सप्रेशन वन मोर रिलेटेड टर्म इज देयर, दैट इज एनर्जी डेंसिटी. दिस एनर्जी डेंसिटी ऑफ कैपेसिटर हेडिंग, इट विल टेल अस दैट अ कैपेसिटर स्टोर्स एनर्जी इन वॉट फॉर्म. सो लेट अस प्रोसीड नाउ. Energy density means energy per unit volume of the capacitor. So suppose we take a parallel plate capacitor whose each plate area is A and the separation between the two plates is D. So overall what volume is consumed by the capacitor, that is area into distance. So AD is the volume. So whatever energy formula we have derived already for the capacitor, that means U formula, this we have to divide by AD, that means volume, so that we get the energy density. So let us follow these steps. Half of CV square is the energy stored in the capacitor. Let us now replace the C and V value for the parallel plate capacitor. C formula for the air filled parallel plate capacitor is A epsilon 0 by D. This we have already derived. Let us substitute A epsilon 0 by D in place of C. And the voltage and electric field are also related by the formula. So V equal to ED. Let us substitute here E into D. D means separation between the plates. Here is square is there, so we'll do square. 1D can get cancelled, so this is left. Now as is the requirement, we want energy density, which is energy per unit volume of the capacitor. So energy upon volume. Volume of this capacitor is area into distance. So area into distance between plates. So AD term we have to divide. But in the numerator also AD term is there. So this AD term will get cancelled. And we are left with half of epsilon 0 E square. You can see that electric field is appearing in this formula. The capacitor is a energy storage device and this stores the energy in terms of electric field. So the answer that in what form the capacitor stores the energy, so the answer is in terms of electric field it stores the energy.